So the only thing that's really gonna help you grow, you have to post content every motherfucking day. Period. You know what I'm saying? That's the only way to grow as a new channel.
Gotta keep it G, gotta speak in code. Never had shit, had to get it on my own. Don't ask me no questions, you know what I'm on. I pull out the chopper and bust out this thing. Am going up, bring my check all the way up.
Peace to the gods. You already know who it is, man. It's the chosen one, Merkaba 13. And in this video, I want to talk about how to grow your brand as a producer, as an artist, as an entrepreneur from zero followers to thousands. You know what I'm saying? Now look, you got to understand this. We all start from zero. You feel me? Even the most popular accounts that you see on social media, we all start with zero followers. You feel me? They all started with zero. And you got to understand that when you're trying to grow something from scratch, when you're building something from scratch, the most important aspect is your passion, your commitment, your dedication, and the love for what you're doing. You know what I'm saying? Like a lot of producers and a lot of artists especially, like niggas have what I call a microwave mentality. You know what I'm saying? They just want shit quick. You know what I'm saying? Like niggas just want to hop in the game and just make millions without putting in no motherfucking work. Like, bro, I didn't make no motherfucking money as a music producer like the first fucking 5-10 years I was doing this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I might have got like a couple little beat sales here and there. Like, I might have engineered a session, got a little money here and there. But as far as like real money that I could eat off of and live off of, bro, that shit didn't happen until I made the motherfucking decision to really take this shit seriously and really treat this shit like it's life or death. Like, bro, if this shit not life or death for you, bro, you know what I'm saying? Then your success is only gonna be minimal, you know what I'm saying? Or it's gonna be short-lived. The most successful people and the people that actually impact people and impact culture with their art or with their message, you know what I'm saying, or with their brand, it's the people that have a real deep devoted love and a certain type of passion behind what they doing. You feel me? Like without passion, without really being dedicated to the craft, like bro, like a lot of producers, a lot of artists, you know what I'm saying, like niggas haven't even perfected their craft yet, but they worried about money. You know what I'm saying? That's a backwards ass way to think. Money follows energy. You feel what I'm saying? So if you want to get money, you can get money. You know what I'm saying? If you want to be successful, you can be successful, but your energy, your actions have to reflect that. You know what I'm saying? So if you're not willing to put in no motherfucking work, and if you're not willing to really grind every day, you know what I'm saying, to get to, you know, the life of your dreams, then you playing. So when you starting from zero, bro, you got to be passionate. You got to be hungry. So that means that you have to be willing to expose your content to as much people as possible any way that you can. You feel me? And a lot of times when you starting with no followers, no type of subscribers, then a lot of times you might not have money to invest. So the only thing that's really gonna help you grow, you have to post content every motherfucking day. Period. You know what I'm saying? That's the only way to grow as a new channel. It's the only way to grow. This is the ground. You have to create a brand identity. And you can only doing that by letting the world know and showing the world what you have to offer. You have to bring other people value. People have to see your page and see what you're doing, and they have to be inspired to take action. Either they have to get some type of inspiration from you, some type of information from you, you know what I'm saying? Or they have to be able to get something of value that gives them an incentive to want to come back and interact with your brand. You feel what I'm saying? And when you can do that, when you can create content that captivates people, when you can create content that inspires people, that educates and informs people, people will want more. Because ultimately, when people are scrolling through social media, you know what I'm saying, they're searching for something. You know what I'm saying? Whether it's entertainment, whether it's knowledge, you need to be the person that is providing them what they are looking for. This is the key to business. It's supply and demand. You know what I'm saying? So as an artist, when you're promoting your art or your music, you have to understand that that's your brand. You feel me? You are your brand. You have to look at yourself like a brand instead of just an artist and a producer. And that means you have to think about, when people see me in my content, what type of thoughts are going through their head? What message am I sending them? How am I bringing them value? How is my content affecting them and moving them to take action. That's the key. You feel what I'm saying? So really the only way to grow as a channel is you have to create dope ass content on a consistent basis. You know what I'm saying? Cause see, here's the thing. When you start from nothing, yeah, you're gonna have to follow some people. You're gonna have to comment on larger accounts posts. You're gonna have to DM a lot of people. You know what I'm saying? But people see this shit. Like, niggas act like they don't see you, but they see you. And if you doing some shit that's different, if you doing some shit that's dope, if you doing some shit, you know what I'm saying, that's worthy of attention, it's gonna get attention. You know what I'm saying? It's just like if a female, you know what I'm saying, posts a picture of her ass, you know what I'm saying, she's gonna get attention. It don't even matter what she look like, because a lot of people are looking for that. That's a lot of people get value from that. You know what I'm saying? So you have to find what makes you unique as an individual, and you have to market that. That's what's gonna separate you from all of the saturation in the market. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of producers just post, you know what I'm saying, the same type of videos. You know what I'm saying? You have to expand. You have to keep people entertained. If it's the same thing every time, people is gonna get bored with that. So you gotta find ways to innovate. You know, and a lot of times for artists, non-musical content is really the key for a musician or artist. And it's hard for artists to grasp this concept. But like I said, when you look at the most successful artists, a lot of time talent is really only like 20-30%. You feel me? It's more so about their personality. It's more so about what they represent, and the type of energy that they bring to the game is really what makes people connect with them. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of time, the most entertaining people are, you know what I'm saying, the most successful artists, because they're able, people can relate to them in a certain type of way. You know what I'm saying? You have to give something people to connect with. You know what I'm saying? So if people are not forming some type of emotional connection, or if people are not having a certain type of emotional response to what you're doing, you know what I'm saying? It's going to be hard to create a lasting impact. So these are all things that you have to think about when creating a brand, when creating a business, is how is my content and how is my message and how is who am I as a person contributing to the lives of others? You know what I'm saying? Because the top people in the game right now, especially in social media, is the comedians, you know, people, the entertainers, the people who can entertain people, is the influencers who can educate and inform and teach people certain things, whether that's through entrepreneurship, products, or however they're doing it. And then you have people who are what I call lifestyle brands. You know what I'm saying? Some people is just naturally cool. They have a certain aesthetic, a certain vibe about themselves. You could be one of those individuals, but you have to find your USP, your unique selling point. What makes you different? You know what I'm saying? Once you find that, you have to understand that you have to document everything in your life. You know what I'm saying? Show people your day-to-day process. Show people what you go through. Show people what you've been through, because your life can be an inspiration to somebody else. You know what I'm saying? So it's all about creating, man. You got to show the world your story. Tell the world your story. Who are you? What, you know what I'm saying? Why should people pay attention to you? You got to give people a reason to buy into you, because time is an investment. When people spend time with you, when people spend time watching you, that's an investment. You know what I'm saying? And that investment can turn into money the more value that you give to them. You feel me? So that's the whole name of the game, man. It's all about content. It's all about stepping outside of the box and the limitations that you have of yourself and learning new skills, learning information. You feel me? You need to be posting on every social media platform as often as you can. And don't just post bullshit. Post things that inspire, that educate, entertain, that bring value to others. You know what I'm saying? And if you have this type of mindset, if you truly try to connect with people instead of just make money, then your account will definitely grow. You know what I'm saying? So it's the chosen one, man, Merkaba13. Please visit my website, www.merkaba13.com. And as always, man, I'm going to leave y'all in peace.